Welcome to the Luxy Hair YouTube channel. My name is Tiana, and today we're gonna be talking about the different kinds of hair extensions. There are so many different kinds of hair extensions out there, and if you're new to the hair extension world, it can be a little bit confusing. So today I'm gonna talk about the 6 most common hair extensions used. So the first hair extension that we're gonna talk about today are clip-in hair extensions, which is actually what I have in my hair right now. Clip-in hair extensions are great to add into your natural hair, and they are completely customizable. They come in a package together but are organized into different wefts. What is a weft, you might ask? A weft is essentially strands of hair that are attached to a silicone or cloth strip, and that is attached to a quad clip so that you can clip it onto your hair and secure it in. If you're someone who likes to switch up your hair a lot, you don't like to commit to one look, you want something quick, easy, and customizable too, then clip-in hair extensions are definitely for you. They take about 5 to 15 minutes, depending on what hairstyle you're doing, to install and to remove. They're one of the least damaging forms of hair extensions because you don't have to add any extra pressure, any chemicals, or install methods. And if the clip-in hair extensions are human hair, like Luxy's, then they're very low maintenance. Essentially, you just treat it like your own hair. So you make sure to brush it and detangle it so it doesn't get knotted. You can wash it like your own hair, so shampoo, condition, and then let it air dry. And also, you can curl it, you can straighten it, you can style it, and you can also dye it. So it really is a unique experience to you. And finally, clip-in human hair extensions can last from 6 months to a year plus. So if you really take care of your hair extensions, you can get so much from just one set. Next is tape-in hair extensions, and they're exactly like they sound. Tape-in hair extensions are pre-taped and then they are taped or glued on either side of your hair. Typically, a hairdresser will install and remove tape-ins because there's a really special method that's used to make sure that everything is aligned and installed properly. For install, a hairdresser will align the tape-ins to the roots and add heat to them so that they are secured. The process takes about 40 minutes to an hour to install, and when you're ready to get them removed, you would have to go back into the hairdresser so that they can remove it with the glue remover. Tape-in hair extensions typically last around 4 to 8 weeks before you have to get them redone, but like any hair extensions, the better you treat it, the longer it's gonna last. For tape-ins, you can style them any way that you want because they are human hair, but you have to really watch out for the roots or the areas that have the glue or the tape. On top of this, tape-in hair extensions can be a little bit tricky to treat. You have to be very careful on what conditioners you are using in your hair because it can actually make the extensions slip off. Hairdressers usually recommend special shampoos and conditioners that are not as oily and are not as harsh so that the glue doesn't slip off. One thing that's really important to note is that naturally when you add any heat or adhesive to your roots, it can be extremely damaging to your hair. So if you are someone who does get a lot of breakage and damage at your roots, this might not be the best option for you. The next most common hair extensions used are sew-ins or weaves. Sew-ins and weaves are also exactly how they sound. Basically, what happens is your hair is braided or cornrowed, and then the wefts are applied by taking a needle and thread and actually sewing the weft to your braids. This can be a really long process, taking a few hours to do, so you definitely want to have an experienced hairdresser to do the process for you. Sew-ins also come in wig form, so basically, instead of having individual wefts, it's all one piece, but the process is the same. This type of hair extension is popular because it's the most permanent and seamless out of the whole bunch. It literally is sewn onto your hair and cannot come off. So it's recommended that you remove your weave after 6 to 8 weeks if you really want your hair to grow and be able to treat it. Though the maximum amount of time that you want to have a weave in is 4 months. Absolute most. One thing that is extremely important is that if you have a weave, you want to make sure that you're still treating your scalp, your nape, and your edges. You want to make sure that even though you have a weave, that you're washing your hair and deep conditioning at least once a week. When people get sew-ins or weaves, they usually use human hair because of how long it's staying in their head. But when it comes to styling, it's the same rules as real hair versus synthetic hair. The application process of a weave can add a lot of strain and tension on your hair because of the cornrows and also because of the added weight that's being put onto your hair from sewing the extensions on. So if you're someone who has thin or lighter hair, this might not be the best option for you because it can actually add a lot of breakage and damage to your hair. So this one's kind of similar to tape and hair extensions in the sense that the extensions are being attached to your hair using glue and heat. This process should definitely be done by a hairdresser. And essentially what happens is either a machine or a heat clamp is used to fuse the glue, the extensions, and your actual hair together and secure the hair extensions. This process takes 3 to 4 hours and should definitely be done by a hairdresser. Fusion and pre-bonded hair extensions are definitely one of the most permanent hair extensions out of the bunch. They last for up to 4 months, but like any hair extensions, depends on how you treat it. It depends on your own hair type, your hair growth. There's so many different factors that can affect how long the extensions stay in your hair. With fusion and pre-bonded hair extensions, it can be treated the same way as your real hair. You can use the same products that you normally use, but they generally need repositioning every 2 to 3 months. One thing to note about these extensions is because of the chemicals and the glue used to attach the extensions on, it can be extremely damaging to your scalp, your roots, and cause a lot of breakage and irritation. The next set of hair extensions are microlink hair extensions, which is also known as microbead hair extensions or microloop hair extensions. These are applied by attaching tiny little wefts to small sections of your hair and then securing it with a silicone lined bead. From there, a special tool is used to tighten the bead and secure it to your hair. This is definitely a method that you'll want to go to the hairdresser for because although it doesn't use any heat, any chemicals, any glue, if it's not installed properly, it can definitely add a lot of damage and breakage to your hair. This damage can be caused by the bead being tightened too much, from the pressure and pulling really close to your roots, and if not removed properly, you can even pull out your actual hair. The whole process takes about 2 to 4 hours to install. For microlink extensions, you can wash and style it the same way that you would with your natural hair, and it lasts about 4 months, but generally you're gonna want to reposition them at the 2 to 3 month mark. The last type of hair extension I want to talk about today that's really common are wigs and hair pieces. Wigs and hair pieces come in so many different forms and colors and are applied topically. Wigs are generally made to cover your entire head and are a replacement for your own hair. There's a lot of different ways that wigs are applied, but the three most common is glueless, sew-in, and glue-on. Hair pieces are a little bit different from wigs because they usually come in pre-styled options like a bun, a ponytail, or a hair tie. They can be specifically used for a certain area of your head, whether that's a stylistic reason or if your hair is thinning and you want to cover it up. So you know how earlier I told you I have clip-in hair extensions? Well, I also have a hair piece. This is a ponytail in my hair just to create more volume and make the hair more full. So you can mix and match. It doesn't have to be used alone. It can be used with other hair extensions that you have in your hair. So for treating wigs and hair pieces, it definitely depends on if the hair is real or synthetic. For a synthetic hair, you're not going to want to wash it, and generally they don't last as long. But for real hair, you can wash it and treat it just as your own hair. So again, similar to the real human hair clip-in extensions, brush and detangle it as normal, shampoo and condition as normal, and then let it air dry. Typically, human hair, full wigs, and hair pieces last up to a year or more. And again, it all depends on how well you take care of it. For synthetic hair, that honestly usually lasts about 1 to 3 months max before the hair starts to noticeably be worn up. And that's essentially it. So those are the most common hair extensions used. And if you're still confused, take the quiz at lexihair.com where you can see which hair extension is right for you. I hope this video helped you learn more about the different types of hair extensions and make your decision on what the best option is for you. Let me know what your favorite go-to hair extensions is and definitely place that in the comments below. And if you haven't already, don't forget to hit that subscribe button and I will see you soon.